So on to the thermal incinerator. The SRU tail gas and sulfur pit degassing vents are sent to the incinerator, where all sulfur compounds are converted to SO2 and then vented out the stack. Higher fuel gas usage and the coinciding CO2 production is associated with excess oxygen. So optimal levels for this oxygen in the stack are 2 to 4% O2. But oxygen analyzers do have a poor track record due to the acidic nature of the stack gas. So knowing our normal fuel gas flow requirements is important, because the more sulfur species remaining in the tail gas, the more fuel gas will be needed to convert it to SO2. Yeah, so that picture on the right, that's what happens when the incinerator runs too hot. Typically, it shouldn't exceed 650 degrees Celsius. And that temperature is controlled by the amount of fuel gas and air being burned. So we at SRU will sometimes conduct an incinerator optimization study, along with the usual performance tests. And these often produce significant savings on fuel gas consumption and greenhouse gas emissions. Our simulation modeling can determine capacity limitations, minimum achievable stack top temperature, and the incinerator kinetic design factor, that's the IKDF. And that describes the relationship between the stack top temperature and the amount of total reduced sulfur species, TRS. So now we'll go over a case study for one of our recent incinerator optimization projects. This was a client in southern Alberta. They brought us in to optimize their incinerator at their new 60% turndown operation. So pretty big turndown. They were licensed for a total reduced solids emission limit of 300 ppm. So we chose a target of 250 ppm for a safe margin. We took samples at various temperatures in 50 degree increments, then used those results in our simulation to determine the IKDF. These samples also give us a comparison with the stack analyzers to determine their accuracy. So once we analyzed those samples and got them in through the simulation software, that spits out an IKDF, the kinetic design factor. And with that, we can develop this curve. And so this finds out the minimum acceptable stack top temperature at the target of 250 ppm total reduced sulfur, TRS. So we start there on the left at 250, go over, and that drops down from our curve at somewhere between 315 and 320. And then for an added 5 degree safety margin, we recommended the final acceptable temperature of 325 degrees Celsius. So the simulation software was able to identify the limitations in terms of reducing combustion airflow and the resulting excess oxygen in the stack. We found that the manually adjustable air louvers were greatly limiting the minimum combustion airflow that could be achieved. There was just too much airflow even when they're almost fully closed. The lower reading limits were also determined with the STT transmitter, that's the stack top temperature transmitter, as well as the minimum acceptable input value for the controller. By reducing the stack top temperature to 325 degrees Celsius, the fuel gas requirements dropped by about 75%. This corresponded to an annual savings of about $30,000 a year, and it greatly reduced the CO2 emissions from the stack. So you can see huge gains there. Dropped the fuel gas requirement by 75%. That's pretty huge.